Yo, so I'm gonna be reacting to Olivia Rodrigo's new album, Guts. I almost know nothing about this album. I know two songs. I know a Vampire and Bad Idea Ride. Vampire, I actually really like that song. I actually do listen to that. I listen to that a lot in Switzerland. Bad Idea Ride, I pretty much only really know it from like TikTok or YouTube Shorts. I don't even know really much about Olivia Rodrigo herself. There are only like four songs that I know from her, which are Good For You, Driver's License, Vampire, and Bad Idea Ride. But other than that, I really don't know any of her music. But the ones that I do know, I didn't really like them at the start, but after listening to them more, I started to really like them. So I'm interested to see if that will be the same for the other songs on the album. Maybe I won't like them during this reaction and then later start liking them. It's very possible. So I have the album here on YouTube. I'm also going to be looking at the videos because I definitely have some opinions on the videos. I've already looked at them. I haven't listened to any of the songs though, as you can see. I have some very strong opinions for why I like and don't like the videos for both of them. But yeah, let's get started with the first song, All American Bitch. I already like the name. Let's listen to it. Okay, let me just pause right here. I'm gonna be completely honest, I don't really like this yet. Her voice is very high pitched. It's annoying to listen to. The guitar also doesn't really hit me. That's my first opinion. But keep in mind, I had the same opinion on all those songs like Vampire, Driver's License. I had this opinion too. And I really love those songs now. I'll just keep playing it. Maybe there's gonna be a part where it like switches up and or something and it's gonna be like really crazy. I mean, the video has a million views, so a million people like it. But yeah, that didn't sound that great to me, to be honest. And I'm all right with the movies that make jokes about senseless cruelty, that's for sure. And I am built like a mother in a total machine. Okay. It's getting better now. So I've got sun in my motherfucking pocket, bless me. Okay. Okay, I like this. Yeah, it's getting better. Yeah, that's what I was waiting for. That's what I was waiting for. That's a banger. Okay, I can whatever I said, just ignore it. Dude, this made up for it. That was sick. Let me go back to that. I want to listen to that again. Okay, yeah, this is a good song. This is sick. Yeah. Bitch. Okay, yes. Okay. What the fuck? These lyrics. Let me go back a little bit. Dude, what was that? Okay, that's I'm loving these lyrics, to be honest. Yeah, this is great. Okay, good song. I like that. That was great. I hope that worked. It was really loud for me, actually, the song. Hopefully that didn't like bleed back into my mic, but Bad Idea Ride. Oh, I have subtitles on. I'll keep them on, actually. Here, now we finally got a music video, which is I have some opinions on it. I'll just play it and I'll comment on it later. Bad Idea Ride. I've already listened to this. I made a short about this, actually. If you want to watch it, it's on my channel. Here, let's just play it. I like this part. Like that. That part. Seeing you tonight.
It's a bad idea, right?
Seeing you tonight.
It's a bad idea, right?
Seeing you tonight.
It's a bad idea, right?
It's funny.
Biggest lie I ever said.
Yeah, I like this song. Okay. I personally don't like these little breaks in music videos because I like to listen to songs on loop. I can go days listening to just one song and just have it on loop. But I can't do that on YouTube because there's a little break. Oh, I can. It's not that bad, but it's kind of annoying. Also, something that really annoys me. Why would you add these black bars on the sides? There's no point in the video where there's anything shown there. So just crop them off. Just have the video be this aspect ratio, which is probably like 4 or 3. So if I full screen the video on my monitor, it's not really a problem because I would get the black bars anyway because the video is just like that. And I actually have monitors that are this shape. Let me actually I'm using it right now. Let me get on my phone. Let me pull out the camera here, let me start recording. Here we go. This is my setup. Like on my monitor, this looks fine, yeah, because the video, like the shape doesn't match. But this is my other monitor that I'm recording on. Oh, look, don't look at my stream alerts. If I move the window to that monitor, like here, and then if I full screen it, look at that. Now I get double black bars. I get black bars at the bottom. And there, this is terrible. That's why you shouldn't do that. And yeah, should I really be using a monitor like this? Probably not, but you can't stop me. This is not good. Okay, there's my little rant. Let me put the phone away. Also, video is 24 FPS, which I've talked about in other videos. I hate it. But it's trying to mimic a film look, so I guess it's fine. But 60 FPS, it just looks so much better. Even 30 FPS looks way better. But yeah, that's my rant about the video. Cinematography-wise, it's really good. Nothing wrong with it. I also like the film grain effect that they added over it. Sucks that YouTube compression ruins it, and there's this new enhanced bitrate that I can't use because I don't have YouTube Premium. But when I was making my short, I wanted to download this video to put it in my short, and I noticed that when I was downloading it, I actually could download the premium version of it, the enhanced bitrate version. So I did that, and it still looks like trash. It's because video encoders don't like film grain because it's random and it's like not predictable. It kind of looks like blocks. I actually think that this non-enhanced bitrate version might look a little bit better because you don't see half grain, half compression. This is just kind of fully compression, which actually might look a little bit better. But yeah, it's just interesting. But yeah, that's my rant about the videos. The same applies to Vampire. But yeah, let's go back into the video. I love that part. I love that. Yeah, I love that. I love these like background vocals.
Tonight. It's a bad idea, right? Seeing you tonight. It's a bad idea, right? Seeing you tonight. It's a bad idea, right? Seeing you tonight. Fuck it, it's fine.
This is a very fun song. Okay, I also saw this in the video. I don't know what this is supposed to symbolize even. This effect, it's cool. Don't get me wrong. I also like the blooming around it. Like, it looks as if it could be real, but I do think that this just being like pretty much white, that's not exactly white, it's a little bit like more yellow, but that's just the color correction, I think. It looks a bit corny. I'm just gonna say it, but other than that, I like it.
Fireworks are cool though.
Blah. Spider. Oh, I just realized something though. The good thing about adding black bars to your video, you have space for the end cards, which is stupid, but at least you do. I hate when end cards like block videos. It's annoying. But I mean, I guess this is a good use for it. Don't add it though. This is not worth it. But yeah, the video itself was good though. The cinematography, it's a video that I really like. I'm obviously nitpicking. You can make the video however you want. If you want to add black bars everywhere, if you want to make the whole video black screen even, if you want, go for it. That's just my opinion. I like the video though. The storytelling also of the song. I think it's a very very fun song. It's also very unique. I don't hear songs like that from other artists usually. This has definitely like a story added to it, which to be fair, other artists do add stories into their music, but this feels different somehow, which is really cool. Don't worry, Olivia, I'm just trying to get you out of a lawsuit in case you copied someone. No, I'm joking. No, let's go to Vampire. Also a video. I don't think anything else on this album has a video, but this is legit one of my favorite music videos probably. So yeah, even with the black bars, and that says something. I'll tell you why. There are two specific reasons why I like it. Also, this water already looks amazing. So yeah, I was listening to this song when I was in Switzerland, and it added some sentimental value to the song, I guess. It's really like, and also to the trip. Whenever I think of Switzerland, I think of this song and vice versa. It's really cool. Also, the storytelling in the video is really good. And also the color grading, look at this. It looks very old. It looks like old film. I don't think they use old film for this. Yeah, the color grading on this looks great. What you can see in a lot of her videos, actually this looks very similar to the other video. This should be bright white, but clearly it's a bit more orange. And that looks good. It definitely has this film look. I definitely don't think they use real film for this. That would be really expensive, first of all. You would lose some freedom too in editing, so I don't think they would have done it. But this looks really good. Vampire. Yeah, again, I don't really like these breaks. It kind of ruins it when you're listening to it on loop, but it adds some story to the video. It's actually, like, it's not that bad. And also, they keep it short, which is good. God, I hate the way I called them crazy. Okay, I want to point this out. You see this? This is an old camera. I think they actually use an old camera for this, which is my specialty. Unless they did a really good job faking it, but this is an actual, I think this is a tube camera, is what it's called. I always wanted to know what this effect was. Sometimes in music videos or old videos that I would see some like motion blur, but it's more like a burn in. Like when something is really bright, it would like draw a line. And I think you can kind of see this here. This does not look like normal VHS to me. This does look like they actually like had like a specific like a tube camera or something, which is really cool. I want one of those. Now the footage from those cameras is still interlaced, I'm pretty sure, so that would be 30 fps, but if you deinterlace it will be 60 fps. But this music video is still 24 fps, so frames have been thrown away, which is sad. But it's cool that they use old technology and they didn't fake it. I still don't think they use real film though, because that would be crazy and kind of pointless. But this is really cool. If anyone knows or was involved with the making of the music videos, I would love to just have a conversation with you. That would be really cool. Yeah, let's keep playing. Yeah, that definitely looks old. I actually don't see the burn in. Oh, yeah, I saw it there. You see this little thing? Yeah, it's definitely burning in a little bit. It's not a long streak though, but it's definitely there. I think this was recorded on a tube camera. Ooh, and those sparks. Ooh, that looks cool. That's actually a really smart use of burn-in. I actually never saw someone actually use it. It's always been accidental. I'll put some more times I've seen it in this Public Image Limited video. I saw it too in his sunglasses. It's always been accidental, but this seems like it was done on purpose. That's actually so smart. I wonder if there was someone like at the production company who was like, yeah, so these old tube cameras, they actually have some burn-in and it looks really cool. Maybe you can do something with like sparks and it makes streaks across the screen. If someone actually thought of that, that's crazy. That's actually really cool. This might still be accidental though, but it's really cool. Yeah, I want to watch that again. The people who made this video definitely know how to make videos. I have a sweet spot for when videos are recorded at night. When I was in Switzerland even, I recorded this one video out of my window. I'll show it on screen. Night videos look so cool, and they make such great use of that in these music videos. Look at this. Holy. Yeah, this is my favorite shot out of all of them, I think. Just the skyscrapers in the back. There's this one channel where they archive old film, and there's this one video of the New York skyline in 1970 something. It's like really old, and it's at night, and it's like a helicopter flying through there, and it just looks magical, and it really reminds me of this. It's so cool. I'll put it on screen, but it's so cool. It just looks magical, and same goes for this video. It looks amazing. Let's play it again. And she's on a crane too, I think, which is interesting. Beautiful. Oh my god, dude, there's lights in the background. Me dry like a goddamn vampire. Imagine just driving there, by the way. You just see Olivia Rodrigo on like a fucking crane with the camera guy. I think there was a behind the scenes video that got posted where you legit just see her standing there on a crane with the camera guy. I don't know, I just think it's funny. But yeah, it's great storytelling. But yeah, this video is amazing. Okay, new song. No videos anymore. You won't get any rants from me anymore about videos. New song called Lacey. Let's listen to it. Well, it's still a video, but it's just lyrics. Lacey, oh Lacey, skin like puff pastry, aren't you the sweetest thing on this side of hell? Dear angel Lacey, eyes white as daisies, did I ever tell you that I'm not doing well? Ooh, I care, I care, I care, like perfume that you wear. This reminds me a little bit of Billie Eilish, which I like. I'm not feeling the song yet, but I'm still waiting for something sick to happen. I know it's gonna happen. Smart, sexy, lazy, I'm losing it lately. It's like you're made of that part was really good. The part, I really like that. The problem that I kind of have with her songs too is that the good parts, it needs to build up. So whenever I listen to her songs, I need to like get past the part that's like kind of good, but it's like it's build up. Sometimes I just want to like, I want to feel really good, and then I have to like wait for it, which is kind of annoying. I don't know. I really like this part though. Lacey, oh Lacey, I just loathe you lately. And I despise my jealous eyes and how hard they fell for you. The lyrics in this are really good. I despise my rotten mind and how much it worships you. Her songwriting is really good. That was a good song. It's not the song that I would usually listen to, I think, but I liked it. I don't really have any complaints. I also don't really have much to say about it though. It's more of like a Billie Eilish song, which is not something I usually really listen to, but it's definitely not bad. It's a really good song. So yeah, let's listen to the next one. It's called Ballad of a Homeschooled Girl. Oh, that's funny. It's a yearbook, but it's only her because she's homeschooled. I like these rock songs. I know. This is cool. So it's just here this time. To just speak about the lyrics, this is about someone who's homeschooled, and when you step outside and social suicide, I feel like that's like social anxiety. I'm gonna be honest, I'm not homeschooled, and for me it doesn't feel any better. So just so you know, that happens to anyone. I have noticed that when I record videos or stream, because it's my own platform, if I don't want to show something, I can just delete it. So I have more freedom, and I am also a bit more outgoing, and I feel like that actually socially helps me a lot too, just because people like it when you're a bit weird online. If I'm a bit weird IRL, maybe sometimes I would think that I don't want to be annoying, so I wouldn't do something. But now I do it more often because people online seem to like it, and that kind of taught me that people don't really care what you do. It's just, as long as you're yourself, people will like that, and people will actually like you more if you do a little bit more. I feel like a lot of people don't understand that. If you don't talk, if you don't socialize with people, they will also not have good memories of you. It's not bad to be a little cringe sometimes. Why is my voice starting to crack? I'm starting to fucking cry. It's not bad to be cringe sometimes. They won't even remember that. They will remember the good parts of you. So just keep that in mind. But yeah, let's go back to this video. Let's go back a little bit.
Searching how to start a conversation on a website. Talked to the top guy, swore I was his type. Guess that he was making out with boys at the whole night. Everything I do is tragic. Every guy I like.
Yeah, don't. I mean, you can search how to start a conversation on a website. This video, I've definitely been thinking through before I started recording what I was going to say about old equipment, like the tube camera. I didn't just pull that out of my ass. I've already seen that video. I've not listened to these songs, but I already know that. That's why that part is the longest part of the video. I thought about that before. That's fine. Laughing at the wrong time is fine, as long as you are honest about it, as long as you maybe apologize if it's actually the wrong time, if you laugh at a funeral. But it's also, people will understand it. People have their own things that they're dealing with, so if you do something wrong, they will care about themselves. Nobody lays awake at night and is like, oh, the thing that PDL did, that was so cringe. I do that, but no one else does that. Everyone else does that for themselves. Just be yourself. That's all I'm really trying to say. I'll probably cut a lot of this out, but people will love you if you're yourself.
Conversation on the website. I talked to the top guy, swore I was.
It's also a lot of practice, by the way. Just have conversations. You'll learn.
His type, guess that he was making out with boys at the whole night. Everything I do is tragic. Every guy I like is gay. The morning after I panic.
I love this part. I love the. Is that a guitar in the background? I don't know. I love that. Not though. It's legit not.
I broke a glass, tripped and fell, told secrets I shouldn't tell. Stumbled over all my words, made it weird and made it worse each day that I'm
This sounds so good. That's funny. Great song. Very, I guess you could call it emotional, but also some humor at the end. Legit, it ticks like all the boxes pretty much. It even got me like talking about social anxiety. How do you get me talking about social anxiety? I don't know. Great song. So let's just do Making the Bed.
Wanted so I got it. Did it so it's done. Another thing I ruined. You
still for fun. Another piece of plastic I could just throw away. Another conversation with nothing good to say. I thought it, so I said it. Took it cause I can. Another day pretending I'm older than I am. Another perfect moment that doesn't feel like mine. Another thing I forced to be a sign. Well, sometimes I feel like I don't.
This sounds very familiar. I like it though. I feel like I've heard something like this before though.
This is the part where I tell you I'm fine, but I'm lying. I just don't want you to worry.
Sometimes I feel like I don't want to be where I am. Getting drunk at a club with my fair weather friends. But it's me who's been making the bed. Me who's been making the bed.
There's a sound in the back. If you were to listen to that sound alone, it's probably awful. Like, it's like a very like distorted guitar, is it? I don't know, maybe it might honestly just be like a synthesizer. I've been hearing it slightly like throughout the song and it sounds so good. I love it.
But it's me who's been making the bed. Me who's been making the bed. Pull the sheets over my head. It's one recurring dream. I'm driving through the city. The brakes go out on me. And I just let it happen. I got the things I wanted. It's just not what I imagined. But sometimes I feel like I don't wanna be where I am. She's over my head. Making the bed.
This is a good song. This is dang. Nice, I like this one. This is not the type of music I usually listen to, but I really like it. Yeah, that was a really good one. It did give slightly high school prom vibes. Like, I can see that being played there and then people like dancing to it. But that's cool. I mean, in a couple of years, you're gonna go back to that video and you'll see comments being like, oh, times were so good back then. And people will make memories to that song, I think. A great song. Let's go to Logical.
Master manipulator, God, you're so good at what you do. Come for me like a savior. I'd put myself through hell for you. Hear all the rumors lately that you always deny. I fell for you like water falls from the February sky. But now the current's stronger. I couldn't get out if I tried. But you convinced me, baby, it was all in my mind. And now you got me thinking 2 + 2 = 5. And I'm the love of your life. Cause if rain don't pour and sun don't shine, and changing possible. No love is never logical. You lied, you lied, you lied.
Let me just pause it there. This part of the song, like, it's kind of like very similar to the start of Vampire, I think. Yeah, this is kind of the build-up part that I was talking about earlier that I didn't really like. It's just, it doesn't really seem to get anywhere. I hope that this is gonna have some like exciting, I mean, it can still be sad, but like something where it will hype me up a little bit, as in like something energetic, something rocky, you know what I mean. So not the biggest fan of this yet, but maybe it's coming.
Oh. 2 + 2 = 5. And I'm the love of your life. I guess love is never logical. The sky is green, the grass is red. You mean all those words you said. I'm sure that girl is really your friend. Problems are all solvable. Cause loving you is loving every argument you have. You could have instead said I was too young, I was too soft. Can't take a joke, can't get you off. Oh, why do I do this? I look so stupid.
Yeah, it always just kind of seems to, like, I just wanted to have a little bit more of a punch, if that makes sense. Also, it's a lot of, like, screaming, if that makes sense. Well, it's not a scream, but it's, like, so high-pitched that, for me, it's, like, almost physically impossible to sing along with this if I wanted to. I mean, I could, but... honestly, yeah, that's just not really what I'm a big fan of. It's kind of annoying to listen to, in my opinion. It's fine, though. The song, it's all right. It's not bad. It's just not really for me, I think. Logical, love is never logical. I know I'm half responsible, and that makes me feel horrible. Oh, logical, logical, love is never logical. I know I could have stopped it all. God, why didn't I stop it all? I like how she changed it up at the end. It did drag out a little bit too much, I think, but I like how it, like, the song was different at the end. Still didn't really like that part either, but I like that it was different. It made it a little bit more special. So yeah, nice song. I wouldn't say great. It's not really for me. I have a very weird music taste, though. I bet that there are a lot of people who are watching this and are like, oh my god, dude, that's my favorite song. Yeah, I mean, that's the nice thing about music. Everyone's taste is different, and that's fine. Let's go to the next song, Get Him Back, with an exclamation point. She excited about it? I met a guy in the summer and I left him in the spring. He argued with me about everything. He had an ego and a temper and a wandering eye. He said he's 6'2" and I'm like, dude, nice try. But he was so much fun and he had such weird friends. And he would take us out to parties and the night would never end. Another song, another club, another bar, another dance. And when he said something wrong, he just brought me to France. Do I love him? Do I hate him? I guess it's up and down. If I had to choose, I would say it right now. Yeah, I like this. I like these types of songs. Yeah, this is maybe a little bit too much, I don't know, to the punk side or something. No, maybe not really, but I like that. Okay, the lyrics are a little toxic though throughout the whole song. Is she bipolar? It's going all over the place. It's pretty toxic. Wanna kiss his face with an uppercut. I wanna meet his mom just to tell her her son sucks. So I wanna key his car. I wanna make him lunch. I wanna break his heart. Stitch it right back up. I wanna kiss his face with an uppercut. I wanna meet his mom and tell her her son sucks. Yeah. I wanna get him back. I wanna make him really jealous. Wanna make him feel bad. Got him. That was an interesting song. Very Olivia Rodrigo, though. Just the sound of it. Like, very, like, pop punk rock. I don't know. This is what I would expect from Olivia Rodrigo. It's a good song. Okay. Actually, let me rephrase that. This is what I would expect from Olivia Rodrigo if I've only heard Good For You. It's, like, kind of stereotypical Olivia Rodrigo, I think. This is one of those songs, which I like. I'm more of a... I think currently my favorite song might be Vampire, though. And that's completely different. Although, that might change, honestly, because I've already heard some songs on this album that are starting to, like, in my head grow on me. So that might change. But yeah, I would call that one stereotypical Olivia Rodrigo. So yeah, let's go to the next song. Love Is Embarrassing.
After I'd known you like a month, and then you kissed some girl.
The little guitar in the background again. Dude, that always gets me, the distortion on the guitars and just like slightly in the background. I love that. And also, lyrics are still a little bit toxic, but it's better. I like this one. Really, I still think, honestly, maybe the first one I listed, which one was that? All American Bitch. That might honestly also be one of my favorites. I feel like that one might have been better than this one. Yeah, this is good. Ooh. Interesting way of saying that. Interesting. I like that one. I don't know why, but then I gave him everything. I like that. I don't know. That's funny. That's cool. Next song, The Grudge. Ooh, this sounds good.
If nightmares each week about that Friday in May, one phone call from you and my entire world was changed. Trust that you betrayed. Confusion that still lingers. Took everything I loved and crushed it in between your fingers. Not doubt you ever think about the damage that you did, but I hold on to every detail like my life depends on it. My undying love, now I hold it like a grudge. Now I hear your voice every time that I think I'm not enough. And I try to be tough, but I wanna scream. How could anybody do the things you did silently?
That sounds so much like the start of Vampire again. I am realizing that that's kind of her style. I don't even know, is it the way she pronounces it? Just the build up? It's something, she builds up the songs, I guess. But usually it's kind of similar the way she does that. I'm starting to notice that, which isn't bad. It's not necessarily what I specifically like, but it's not bad.
Give, but I don't feel strong. Arguments that I've won against you in my head, not knowing my heart. Hurt people, and we both drew blood.
That's a bar. Hurt people, that's true. Dang, that's cool. I like that line.
So unhappy, not knowing my heart. Hurt people, and we both drew blood. But man, those cuts were never equal, and I try to be tough, but I wanna scream. How could anybody do the things you did so easily? And I say I don't care, I say that I'm fine, but you know I can't let it go. I've tried for so long.
I like the repetition in that too. I've tried. It's so unique. I like that.
Everything and you still want more. Try to be tough, try to be mean. But even after all this, you're still everything to me. And I know you don't care. I guess that's fine. But you know I can't let it go. I've tried for so long. Take strength to forgive, but...
Okay, interesting song. I honestly, I don't really like this one, as in like music wise I probably won't really listen to it much again. Out of all the ones that I said, well, that's not really the type of music I listen to, this is probably the furthest from my music taste. But I like the lyrics. It's a cool song. Number 11, Pretty Isn't Pretty. I like the start. Just stop eating cake on birthdays. That's good.
There's always something in the mirror that I think looks wrong. Pretty isn't pretty enough. What do you do? Everybody's keeping it up. She thinks you. I could change up my body and change up my face. I could try it.
Don't do it.
Lipstick.
Okay, the interesting message of the song. I do want to point this out. You don't need to be pretty. You can be whatever you want, and that's what I'm doing. I could put makeup on. I've done that in another video. Click the card up there if you want to watch that. If you want to wear makeup, go for it. If you want to, I dye my hair. I do that. It's not because I want to be pretty or anything. It's just cool to do that. It's cool to express yourself in a way that you want to express yourself. You're living your life. You're not living someone else's life. What you want to look like is your own choice. It's not about being pretty. It's about looking like something you want to look like. And if that is a lot of makeup, if that is plastic surgery, that's fine. But I personally don't think that will define pretty. I've also seen it go wrong a few times. Just try to do what you can to look the way you want to look, not the way someone else wants you to look. You don't need to be pretty to be happy. And you also don't need to be pretty to be loved. That's sad. Yeah, dude, again, just do what you want. Okay, heavy song, but sound good. I like the song. And now we're at the last song. It's called Teenage Dream. I just got a realization. A few years ago, or maybe a year ago, I wanted to write a song, and I think I called it the same thing. It was either... Yeah, I think I called it Teenage Dream. I still want to make a song, but I'm not talented. Well, I'm not talented enough. I just don't know enough, and I'm scared to do it. I don't know. I should honestly just do it. The song went something like, Teenage Dreams, remember what happened? This girl, she finally gets... That's it. Dark nights with a happy ending. I finally had it. The things I remembered. Something like that. Oh, the things I imagined. No. Teenage dreams, remember what happened. This girl, she finally gets it. Dark nights with a happy ending. I finally had it. The things I imagined. That's kind of how the song went. I never really did anything with it. I would love to make a song still, but I just don't really know how. Like, making a beat for that or something. I don't know how to play any instruments. I would love to learn how to play guitar. Maybe I'll do that on a stream at some point. I would love to make that a song at some point. So yeah, my song would have been called Teenage Dreams probably, but it's pretty similar to Teenage Dream. So yeah, let's see how Olivia did it on the last song of the album.
When am I gonna stop being wise beyond my years and just start being wise? I'll blow out the candles, happy birthday to me.
You better eat that birthday cake though.
And I'm sorry that I couldn't always be your teenage dream. I'll blow out the candles, happy birthday. That they already got all the best parts of me. And I'm sorry that I couldn't always be your teenage dream. They all say that it gets better. It gets better the more you grow. Yeah, they all say that it gets better. It gets better, but what if I don't know?
This is cool. I like the second part. What a sad way to end the album. That was really good. This was such a good album. Like, really, really good. I love it. Dude, this was so good. I do think some of the lyrics were a bit toxic and maybe could have sent the wrong message. And I really hope that some of those things won't be, like, normalized. But I think Olivia was trying to send the right message. And I just feel like they could be misunderstood. But yeah, this was such a good album. And I'll definitely listen to it more. Thank you so much if you made it to the end. Check out my Discord, discord.gg/pdl. And if you want to catch any of my streams, check out my Twitch. Mostly playing Minecraft. I'm honestly not even a reaction YouTuber, but I still love doing this. I'm so glad that I did. This was a pretty emotional album and it was really good. I'm so happy that I made a video about this. This will take ages to edit. I've been recording for 1 hour and 57 minutes, almost 2 hours. I've been recording. I'm gonna keep this recording going for 3 more minutes. I won't keep it in, but this recording's gonna be 2 hours. I'm gonna have to edit all of that. But yeah, thank you so much for watching. Make sure to subscribe and I'll see you later. See ya. And now I gotta stretch the recording for 2 more minutes because I'm petty like that. 2 hours of recording. That's crazy.